Alright, so I thought I'd do another video. Last time I did the Atari collection that they released, the 50th anniversary. And this time I want to talk about the Recharged series. Now the Recharged series, what they do is they take the games and they kind of modernize them. Put in, you know, better graphics, special effects, but they keep the core gameplay the same. And I've had a really good time with these. And so far, they have released Asteroids, Centipede, Breakout, Yara's Revenge, Missile Command, Gravatar, and Black Widow. I don't have these in any particular order. I put them in alphabetical as far as the videos are going to come. And I'll just talk a little bit about each one. And the first one we're going to talk about is Asteroids. And that is arguably the best one on here. I've had a lot of fun with this. So as you see, it keeps the graphics rather simple, kind of the same as the old Asteroids, but it adds a little bit more effects, the space looks a little bit better, explosions look a little bit better, the sound is a little bit better, and everything is just a little bit better. But then they add these power-ups, like the 7-shot, which doesn't go as far, but it releases a spread of shots. Then they have like the forward and back shot. They have one that when you shoot it creates a black hole. It's really cool. This one I've actually had a lot of fun with. And when I get to the end, I'll rank them my favorite to least favorite. But they're all good. If you're fans of the game, you should enjoy these. These are actually really good. The next one is Black Widow, and I never really liked this game growing up. Couldn't stand it in the arcade, didn't quite understand it as far as on a console and everything. I think I was just too young, but playing it here, it's actually kind of cool. And they do reuse a lot of the same power-ups, like the 7-shot here as the spread that doesn't go as far, but this is kind of a mix between, I don't even know what this would be a mix of, but definitely Asteroids. And a little bit of Centipede, maybe. And so it's kind of a mix of those. It's actually a pretty fun game. And the power-ups are really cool. And you build up enough to where you can shoot out your webs and destroy everything on the screen. Well, within the cone of the power-up. And then you go collect the dollar signs, then it builds up your cone power again. And that's a really fun game. Next is Breakout, and one of the problems that Breakout has, and this one shares this problem, is using the controllers to move the paddle back and forth is kind of hard. They've always had this problem with the regular joysticks doing this. Usually, you know, back in the 2600 AD, you had the round paddle, and you could move it around like that. At the arcade, it was a round paddle. The Atari 5200 joystick did really well because it didn't auto-center and to where it was analog, wasn't digital, and so you could move it wherever you want and leave it in the position that you want without having to worry about it moving. But they did a good job, though, and the power-ups are kind of fun. The next one is Centipede, and Centipede is one of my favorites, too. I haven't really developed an absolute favorite, but I have, and so we'll get to that at the end. There's some of them that I think are really good. Centipede is definitely one of them, and I love the power-ups. I love the way this game plays. They just did a fantastic job on this. If you're thinking about getting one, Centipede wouldn't be a bad option to go with first. The next one is Gravatar Recharged. I was never a fan of Gravatar. And so, to have it on here, it plays the same. I mean, it does the same. It's, to me, it's not very exciting, although it is a good-looking game, and it's actually not bad. I never got into it. I never saw the draw to it, but then I was also young. And so, you know, I will give this more time, try to figure it out, try to get an appreciation for it. But if you're a fan of Gravatar, this is kind of a cool remake. Okay. The next one is Missile Command. Mystical Command was one of our favorites in the arcade growing up. He had the big trackball, which you moved the cursor around, and then the three buttons that controlled which silo shot out the missiles. And it was a lot of fun. This one does the same thing with power-ups. So you'll see ships going by, and when you defeat the ships, they drop power-ups. So same idea. It was just the game as it really was, but just added the cool power-ups. You know, and it's fun. It is a decent game. Funny story about this one real quick. I got this on my Nintendo Switch, and they had this for $2, and it was a mistake. But I bought it, and the day later it was taken down because it wasn't out yet, and it was going to be $10. But I got it for $2, and so I'm happy about that. Next game is my favorite. This is Yara's Revenge. They call it Yara's Recharged on this. But if you ever played Yara's Revenge back in the 2600 days, which I think I got that one when I was 8, I loved the game. Now, the beauty of this game is that they made it as simple as the old one. Simple mechanics, simple gameplay. But they added a ton. They added different maps, different setups, different power-ups, different enemies shooting at you. The blocks have different density, so it takes more hits to kill them. They just did a really good job on this. And, you know, I enjoy this one a lot. Now, out of all of these, I would have to say Yara's Recharged is my favorite one. Followed up with a tie between Asteroids and Centipede. And then probably Black Widow, Breakout, and then Gravatar. But they're all good. Now let me tell you a little secret to these. Wait till they go on sale. They're $10 each, which isn't a bad price for a good game. But wait till they go on sale, because normally when they go on sale, they go on for 50% off. So for $5, you can get a really good game. So would I suggest picking these up? Absolutely. If you have any interest at all in the old Atari games, these are fantastic remakes that are actually really fun. If you're an achievement hunter, they're pretty easy on the achievements too. But they are fun. And then that's kind of the bottom line. But always wait till they go on sale. They have a few of them on sale right now on Xbox for $5. You know, they are worth picking up. And they are fun. They will provide hours of fun. My son, who was, you know, I showed him the old 2600 games. He wasn't too excited about them and everything. But he played this and he actually really liked it. His friend Kyler came over and started playing this, and he wouldn't stop playing it. It's good. It is a good, fun game. Well worth your money. So Yara's Revenge, definitely the top of the whole heap there. Followed by Asteroid Centipede. And then Black Widow. Breakout isn't bad. If you love Breakout, you might be able to put up with the control. It's not horrible. They did do a good job with it. But again, it's that lack of the analog stick. That's the hard part. The non-centering analog stick. Which, like I said, the Atari 5200 did it perfectly. If not, then get this on the PC so you can use your mouse or something like that. But just good stuff. Anyway, that's the Atari Recharged. Highly recommended. They are fantastic. So until next time. Have a good one.